Today I'm here at the NZDA Expo in Wellington, New Zealand, and I'm here with Eric Chang from Clarinav talking about the fourth generation Navident, the Navident Evo. And Clarinav have been making the Navident for almost 20 years now in all areas of medical navigated surgery. And this is a pretty interesting tool. So we're going to get a demonstration from Eric and show us all of the cool things the Navident can do and how you might be able to use it in your dental practice. So Eric, what's the new, I guess, functionality we can get with navigated surgery, and what does Navident 4 bring to the world?
Okay. First, we launched a new camera here. We call the MT4. It means a Micron Tracker 4 generations. Most important part is it's a motorized camera. So it will be always tracking the tracking system from the patient side or even from the instruments. That is the first thing.
So that's beneficial, I'm guessing, because sometimes they might not set up the camera perfectly. So what do we have, both rotating head and the cameras rotating? So we got like full 360 sort of coverage?
Yes, correct. Basically, the cart is providing like the 180 degrees from the cart. But with the camera, it's also providing the vertical turns 90 degrees and the left to right horizontal another 175 degree automatically to following and the tracking.
That's pretty impressive. Okay, so yeah, in other systems I've seen, you've got a fixed unit, and if you go outside the area, you're messed up, right? And you've got to reorient yourself. So that's really convenient. I thought it was pretty interesting when you were talking before off camera about the different attachment options that we've got for the patient. Can we go through those?
Yep, sure, of course. First one, there's two things. This is for the maxilla. We call it a head tracker. So if today you have a surgery for the maxilla surgery, single implant, or zygomatic, or even the pterygoid, you can easily using this one, just put on the patient's head. Or we have another one we call the jaw tracker. So it's kind of easier to using the composite to attach to the patient's tooth, interdental, or you can using the putty, bioregistration material, take another 1 minute to attach to the patient's tooth, or even more convenient if today, like the fully dangerous case, or on 4, or on 6, or even just like a removable solutions for patient, take 3 1.5 millimeter bone screw and do the fixation. Yep.
So great options regardless of where you're at. So great to see it's the MaxFax covered as well, and not just dentists.
Yes, sure. So here's everything you need to do for the surgery. Tracking system on the handpiece, and the calibration for all the instruments, and the tracer tool, and the tracking system on the patient. That's all.
So on the instrument side of things, do we have to buy a specific drill, or what's the options there?
Okay, totally not. Here's the very important part is, people will say, if I buy a system, if for just one indication, that'll be way off, right? But if today, you just need to take the normal CBCTs, then do the planning, consultation, and for the surgery, that depending on which instrument you attach to. First, if you attach to the, let's say, surgical motors, you can do the implant surgery. Or today, you attach to the piezo, the piezo sword, you can do the bone cutting surgery, sinus elevations, or even like you do the autogenous bone harvesting, or you can also attach to the high-speed rotary instrument or ultrasonic for endo treatment, calcified canal or episiotomy. Yep.
So we can use our CBCT data for so many different applications, not just implants.
Yes, correct. 100% correct. Yep.
All right. I think one of the other things I thought that was really interesting is how quickly this calibrates. Yeah, really the setup process is incredibly fast.
Yep. So the thing is, when you've done the planning parts, so the patient size, first, of course, for the patient preparation, it's take 1 or 2 minutes to attach to the composite or biomaterial. Or you can use the head tracker, of course. After that, we do the patient's trace registration. It means we will merge the digital data and the patients. So let me demonstrate this part for you. So here's a camera. basically it will detect the patient tracking systems and the tracer tool or calibrator automatically. What we have to do, just show to the camera. Then now it's calibrating. And here's a patient come looking for 014 or 016 treatment. So we press the bone screw, then take the CBCT, do the planning with our planning software. Then now on the screen, you can see there is a 1, 2, 3 different bone screw. So we just need to show to the camera, move to the first bone screw here, touch, then move to the second one here, and move to the last one. Done, just 5 seconds or 10 seconds. After that, we do accuracy check to make sure the registration is correct. Yeah, it's how easy it is. Yeah.
Very easy, and definitely a lot faster than what I've seen in other systems. So you've really polished this whole thing down, and I love the compactness of the attachment on the handpieces too. Yeah. Really convenient and lightweight.
Yep. So next step is the calibration of the instruments. So again, you just need to attach to our calibrator and show to the camera. Everything just happened automatically. So now you get the handpiece orientations. Next steps, just using your surgical drill, then calibration again. 5 seconds, that's all. Then now you just need to move to your planning site. So there is a one target here and a two section view. But more easy way is just always focusing on the bullseye here. So you get the orientation from the screen and also get the depth indicator from the screen here. So if you close to your targets within 1 millimeter, then the color will change to the yellow. And if you achieve to the gold, it becomes to the red one.
So one of the other things we can do is bone cutting rather than just drilling. Can we see how that works?
Sure, of course. Sometimes we have to attach to the different instruments. Like for the full arch, we will do the bone leveling. So now we can switch to the piezo. Only we have to do just recalibrate the different instruments. So now it's a saw mode here. So again, calibrations, show to the camera. After that, we just need to calibrate the tip again. Done. And now we have the two section view from here and the one 3D model view from here. So once your instrument touch to the bone surface, and you will get the PSO cutting view from the screen. Yep. And I will say it's very convenient and also precisely safety to provide you all the information from the screen. If you move too close to the canal or nerve, the system will guide you and alarm you.
That's incredibly helpful feedback to have live in a surgery, which is obviously very difficult. You can plan it, but having that live feedback is going to be invaluable.
Yes. And the last part I want to show you that is amazing, because you can see this one is how compact it is. First, you can totally folding the camera here and fully folding back. And you just move to anywhere. If you have the 3 different operation room, and you can just very easily move from 1, 2, 3. Yep.
Something I just noticed when you were demonstrating that, you unplugged it and it's still running. Yep. So we've got a battery backup on board?
No, I will say it's a safety issue. So we always recommend you have to connect the power to the laptop and the camera. Yep.
Yeah, but just for moving it around, you can unplug it for a short period of time?
Sure, of course, yep.
Very convenient, so we don't have to shut it all down and start it back up again.
No, you don't have to, yep.
So when this was released at IDS this year, I think you also teased some photogrammetry capabilities of the unit.
Yes, because we launched a new generation of the micron trigger four. The accurate is come to like the 60 micrometer, that means 0.06 millimeter. So we have two separate products. First one we call MicroMapper. That's for the imprint position capture. And because we're using the same camera, we add the same function, photogrammetry with a Naviden Evo. And you just need to put the scan body in the patient's mouth, then you pop up the printing software again, then you just tap in the patient's name, select the upper jaw or lower jaw, then will be captured the scan body automatically. Yep.
Okay, so later this year we can expect a 60 micron accuracy photogrammetry capabilities in this as well. And if you wanted to, you can go and buy the micron mapper separately, yep. But we're here, we've got both navigated surgery and the photogrammetry soon to be able to be in both two functions in one unit.
Yes, correct.
So, Eric, where do we get one of these if we're in Australia or New Zealand?
Oh, well, luckily we find the iVocare as a partner for us in Australia and in New Zealand. So if you're looking for more detailed information or demonstration, please contact iVocare. Yeah.
All right, iVocare, great company. I'm sure they'll give people excellent support. Yeah. So great choice in a distributor.
Yes. I believe that will be a win-win partner, not for us, also for our clients. Yeah.
Exciting times. Well, thank you for your time. It's been really interesting to see all of Eric and great work from Clarinav, and it's going to be exciting times for the world of digital dentistry and what we can all look forward to in improving the accuracy and safety of our surgeries. Thanks for your time.
Thank you very much. Thank you.